Hello everyone, it's good to be with you again today. Today we are going to talk about two brothers, Cain and Abel. I'm really looking forward to this lesson, but first, let's sing together.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord is my strength. And the joy of the Lord is my strength. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. And the joy of the Lord is my strength. 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 And the joy of the Lord is my strength. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. He gives me living water and I thirst no more. And the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Last week, our memory verse was Genesis 3, verse 23. So the Lord God banished him from the Garden of Eden to work the ground from which he'd been taken. Today, our memory verse is Genesis 4, verse 6a. Then the Lord said to Cain, "Why are you angry? Why is your face downcast? If you do what is right, will you not be accepted?" Let's say that again. Genesis 4, verse 6a. Then the Lord said to Cain, "Why are you angry? Why is your face downcast? If you do right, will you not be accepted?"
touching the floor. Whoa! Okay, and then when I count to three, we're gonna jump up all together as high as you can. You guys ready? One, two, three.
Ever wanted a toy or a book or something that somebody else had? Or maybe your brother or sister got a treat or something that you didn't, and you wished that that thing was yours. Maybe somebody got a better grade than you in school, and you were mad at them because you didn't get the good grade. Maybe you saw somebody with a really nice house and you wished that that house was yours. Or you saw a girl that you thought was pretty and you wished that you were that pretty. Those are all examples of wanting something that somebody else has. That's what it means to be jealous. In our story today, an older brother is jealous of a younger brother. We read about Cain and Abel and what happened in Genesis 4, verse 1 to 16. Please watch this video with me to see what happened.
After being driven from the Garden of Eden, Adam and Eve started their tough life on the earth, tilling the soil, cultivating vegetables and fruits, keeping cattle of different types, and so on. After some time, Eve gave birth to their first child. They named him Cain. Years passed by. Now Cain has got a little brother too. His name was Abel. Both grow bigger, helping their parents in farming. Cain was more interested in tilling the soil and cultivating different types of plants, whereas Abel took interest in keeping the flocks. Abel was a very pleasant boy, showing affection even to his cattle. And you know, there was an unhealthy competition growing up in Cain's mind towards his brother, as we see nowadays in most of the families. Abel was so generous in all his deeds, showing his respect and love to God, his parents, his brother, and even to his sheep. One day, Abel came with a fat, smart goat for the offering to God.
Yahweh, my Lord, please accept my small offering. Thank you so much, Lord, for blessing me with the healthy flocks I have. Everything I have is out of your mercy alone.
Cain brought a basket full of vegetables and fruits to God while he was walking across his garden. Now Yahweh was well pleased with Abel and his offerings, but towards Cain and his offerings, he showed no pleasure at all. This made Cain very angry and downcast.
Cain, why are you angry and downcast? If you do right, why do you not look up? But if you do well, will you not be accepted? And if you do not do well, sin is lurking in the door. Its desire is for you, but you must control it.
Abel, come on. Let's go to the fields. I will show you something that is very interesting.
They both went walking. Once they reached a no man's land, do you know what happened?
Yes, he's dead. Yeah, finally my biggest enemy is gone forever. Oh, I am in peace now. I am in peace.
Cain, stop there. Where is your brother Abel?
I don't know. How do I know? Am I my brother's keeper?
What have you done? I know everything. Your brother's blood cries out to me. And now you are cursed from the ground, which has opened its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you till the ground, it will no longer yield to you its strength. You will be a refugee and a wanderer on this earth.
No, no, my lord. Don't punish me like this. I know what I did was wrong. Today you have driven me away from the soil, and I shall be hidden from your face. I shall be a fugitive and a wanderer on the earth, and anyone who meets me may kill me. Lord, have mercy on me, please.
Well, at least you have agreed that you are guilty. But sorry, I can do only this much for you. Whoever kills you, they will suffer vengeance 7 times of it.
Yahuwah put a mark on Cain so that no one who came upon him would kill him. Then Cain went away from the presence of the Lord and settled in the land of Nod, east of Eden.
This is a very sad story of two brothers. Both had all the opportunities to live a good life, but the sin that Adam and Eve brought into this world was passed on to their sons, because Cain was jealous and angry, and he murdered his brother. What can we learn from the story of Cain and Abel? We learn that disobeying God brings trouble and unhappiness, but if we obey God, we can be happy while we live our lives on earth. We should also take notice that even though Cain was punished for what he did wrong, God still loved him and protected him. He would not allow others to harm Cain. Let us pray. Father, we want our lives to be acceptable to you. Help us to let you be in control of our thoughts and actions. Help us to follow your commands and obey you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now we can close this lesson with one more song, so please sing with me.
I'm gonna serve.
And now you guys have some time to do the activities that go with this lesson. I hope you have a lovely day, and I'll see you all next week. Bye-bye.